live with my lovely friend Malar. And as you've probably noticed, we're not in my office as usual. We are in the Booktopia store in Festival City Mall. So we're going to be chatting all things literacy and some book advice for you. I know I'm asked all the time at the nursery, oh, Miss Laura, what books would you look for this? Or what books these celebrations for? Or like, all those kind of things. So we're going to have a chat with Malar, who we'll introduce in just a moment. We'll have a little look around the store, see what we can find. And most excitingly, we have the announcement as well of our Instagram competition. Okay? So we'll just wait for a couple more people to join, and then we'll get started. If you've got any questions or anything like that that you'd like to ask, if not for me, maybe for Malar, feel free to add them in the comments, and we'll answer questions at the end. Okay, so I think we're at about 3 o'clock-ish now, so let's get started. So good afternoon, everyone. If you missed earlier, we are live at Booktopia in Festival City Mall, the most amazing little bookshop in Dubai, in my opinion. So let's meet the owner, who we're going to be chatting to today. Hello.
Hi guys, how are you? Welcome to Booktopia. It's a pleasure to have all of you here at the store. Thank you so much, Laura.
Thank you. You know it's one of my favourite places. I come here all the time. quite often you find me and my little boy in here. So, Malar, tell us, how did you get into this? How did Booktopia happen?
Booktopia store and Dubai Festival City Mall happened just 1 year back, but Booktopia happened in Dubai 3 years back. Even before that, we've been in the book industry for over 25 years now. So this is what we do, and this is what I love. But when I came to Dubai in 2016, it was a year of reading. And I was fortunate enough to be part of the government's reading box, where I also started to read reading. And I also understood that there's more scope for an independent bookstore here. And I really like all children of Dubai. I had people just coming in groups for my reading sessions, and I said, you know what, it's time you start a bookstore.
And it's beautiful. So you mentioned, and what we talk lots about is the benefits of reading. So we always use books in the nursery, we always talk about why it's so important. So for us, we start reading with them before they can walk.
Yes,
to be honest, right? And all the way up until they go to school, and hopefully that love of books and literacy and things continues with the children. So what are some of the benefits, you think, to reading with your children as well? Not just them reading by themselves, but with your children. So what do you think?
So, co-reading.
Yeah.
Or reading with the children, I feel is very important.
Yeah.
And there are two parts of this question. I've also talked about the benefits of reading with the children, and I also talk about how you can do that. One, it's very, very important to start early, and you can even start reading to your children, to your babies, even when they are inside your tummy, because your voice is an instrument to associate with your child. The children can associate with someone can't hear. I really don't mind you reading. So it's like we have a lot of new kids here now. So first step is the child actually listens to the parents' voice. It's more of an association. You kind of create a connect, and we always say talk to the child. And now we've given you some content to read to the child. So it makes it more interesting for you. But if it is not so, you can't do that. You can start even when children are babies. Now, apart from the popular known thing that reading improves vocabulary, which it does, and also improves communication skills, it also instigates or initiates a lot of, it acts as a catalyst to the creative development of the child. So, when you read Jack and the Beanstalk to the child, you're talking about Jack and his magic beans, which is going up, but
you're also telling the child that, you know, your imagination can grow.
Yeah, absolutely. And it kind of sparks that creativity in them. And then they'll go and do that by themselves in their imaginative play, or they'll go and dress up, or they'll paint a picture, or some of the older children will start to rewrite the stories or make up their own stories. It really is like a catalyst of creativity. And that's something we do at our group. And it's part of our curiosity approach, which is all about awe and wonder. And yeah, we just love books. We have them everywhere we are in the nursery. And it's not just about the story of the book, but also the content of it, so the different materials. Like, you're not going to buy a baby, junior doctor's book.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So you have different types of books.
Yes, absolutely. And when we look at the Early Years Foundation stage, the curriculum for the children, it starts off at birth and all the way up to kind of 4 years. And it's five actually, and it goes from things like looking at pictures and then looking at books independently, and not just reading the books but seeing the different texts, looking at the pictures.
It's also hand-eye coordination. It's also the color images like, if I always say this, the publishers of today have done a phenomenal job of creating such interesting books. We have pop-up, we have beautiful,
you have material books as well, so
we have these kind of sensitive learners, and those are the kind of books that can initiate the child also to help spark the curiosity of the child, right?
Yeah. And then as they get older, it's kind of knowing which way to pop. Right.
Yeah.
So it's knowing that this is the right way the book goes, this is how we turn the pages. And it's also about respecting the books as well, so as they're older, they know how to look at them. And then it's also going from a few words on a page to those rhyming words.
Yeah.
And those children are so smart, they remember the books. I mean, I don't even need to look up by going on a bear hunt anymore. Like, we can read that by heart, right?
Have you also seen that when you read that to children, you think that you're reading it over and over again? And some children want to read, but you know, every single time they have a different voice modulation, they try to bring their own version of the story.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what their brain is playing out. It's a beautiful position of your left brain and right brain, right?
Yeah, so they develop their memory, their cognitive development, supportive, their language development. There's so much in reading, and there's something for everybody.
There's something
for
everybody.
So let's start from the beginning. So are we going to go on a walk?
Yeah, of course, I can take you around.
Can we go for a walk?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go and find some books for the kind of under twos, the first early readers.
Done.
Okay, let's go.
For under two children, they're still very young, and this one is, for them, everything is, it's more of exploring books, right? Mm-hmm. So, and they're babies, so the discipline of holding the book, reading the book, it's their way of approaching things is to break it and tear it. So I always ask parents and suggest that they go for board books.
Okay.
You know, and board books where it's easy for them, the board books like just sturdy, you know, which have bright color books like this, so even if you drop it, you know, and it's also attractive.
Very attractive. And it's really cute. We're gonna have like the flaps,
and you know,
and there's a lot of repetition usually.
Yes,
in the
there's
books,
a lot
right?
of repetition. We have all the famous books, even for babies. If you see, for babies, mm-hmm. you should give them these kind of small books, which also helps their motor skills.
Yeah, and it learns them. They've got the animals in there,
and
the sea.
Again, the bright color pictures.
Is that Eric Carl?
This is Eric Carl, yes. We love Eric
Carl. A very hungry caterpillar for us.
Yeah.
So then we move on a little bit. So we've gone under two. So what about twos to threes? By this age, they're kind of quite independent in choosing their books as well. They know what they like. So what have you got?
For them, I would suggest something called tactile books.
Okay.
So tactile books and books with sound and music is what I usually suggest.
Yes, the noisy books.
Noisy books.
They love music. They love pressing the buttons.
Yes.
Wow.
Even like, so the under two books and two to three books are the developing stage for the motor skills and sensory. So for both age group, we can introduce touch and feel books and the sensory books where, you know, there are different fabrics. The touch and feel books have, the different sensory things. Like, you know, we have soft, we have a bit rough, there's plastic, there's wood.
puts up all of that. For 2 to 3, I would like to introduce something like called tactile books.
Yeah.
A lot of tactile books are books that can move, and there's some kind of interesting element to capture the child's attention. So if you see, this is a small story, but then there's a small moving element.
Yeah.
You know, the child gets really, really interested.
I really like this range as well, because they do things like this, friends.
And it's
really
still
simple,
board book.
And it's still board book.
So it's easy for parents.
And then you've got these noisy
sound
ones.
Yeah.
The green tractor. I mean, that's just so cute. I mean,
yeah.
On the farm. And they compress as they go. And then I know sometimes you have the Osborne books as well, like the noisy animals.
We have it here like this.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
So this is again, the child, you can ask the child, can you show me where the frog is? And you know, so the child is gonna find the frog for you. That is also.
And then they start to do it independently, don't they? Okay, so we've done our toddlers. Now we're going to kind of over threes. And by this age, they might have really specific interests. So what we tend to find is some of the children are, well, dinosaur obsessed,
yes,
or space, or transport, or books, or some of them just really like stories that they can remember. When I think of the same group, I always think of Julia Donaldson, for example, or Nick Sharrow, or those kind of, yeah, Bob Lowe, and all those kind of stories. So what suggestions would you make for
that? You actually made a brilliant point if you observe that by now the child actually understands what he wants. So I think as somebody who loves books and the book lady, I would really request parents to understand that point, that now children would want to choose.
Yeah, get them involved.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So
bring them, let them choose, let them have a look around.
Give them that choice.
Yeah.
Yes, there are so many books that you would love to introduce, but give them the choice. But you can still introduce a lot of books with their favorite characters as the main character. We can, like Gruffalo, Julia Donaldson's Gruffalo, we have the Rainbow books, we have Elmer, we have Charlie and
I really like Oliver Jeffers' books as well, because they have lovely messages in. So it's not just necessarily about enjoyment sometimes, but there's really clever little messages in
like
books.
How to Catch a Star, for example, if you see. It's about a little boy who wants to catch a star.
Yeah.
And so there's, and it's really, really beautiful. Or Goodnight Moon, which is a classic.
Yeah.
Last year was its 100th year.
Wow.
100 years. And it's still fresh.
Yeah.
It's
really nice. And it's like the mob book as well. The Tiger Who Came to Tea. That's one of our favorites.
Don't let the pigeon drive on the bus.
Oh, wow.
Don't let the pigeon drive the bus. So this is again, this is 30 years old now. So these are the books that we can actually introduce to them.
Amazing.
So we call these picture books.
Okay.
So the picture books are big pictures, one or two lines, so not to intimidate the child.
No, that's really good for supporting them to read independently as well.
Yeah.
So Malar just doesn't have books here for enjoyment, but also we were talking earlier about supporting children with different transitions that they go through. So at the moment at nursery, we have a lot of children who are toilet trainers. Do you have any kind
of
toilet training books?
Yeah, I can show you some.
To support the families, like sometimes it's just a way of introducing it to the children as well. I saw one earlier over there that I really liked. And I saw it and I was like, oh, that's really clever because it answers some of the questions.
Yeah.
Why do we need a potty? And I know that you usually have the Pirate Pete book as well.
Yes, we do have a lot of them.
I really like this one. Why do we need a potty? So you can stop wearing nappies. And it's got all the lift the flaps and it answers the question. So you're actually explaining what's happening to the child. And then it shows you all the different pants that you have. But again, really interactive. It says, what's a potty for? And it tells you the books that we have. It tells you how to do a wee in your potty. Can you play with your potty? Really child friendly, really interactive. Oh, Malar's got an armful of books.
So we also can introduce this one if you see. So seriously, these are books that parents always ask us. If you see, this one is like a potty.
Yeah.
Can you see it's a potty seat?
And you have one for girls, one for boys, right?
We also have Pirate Polly, because children love pirates.
Yeah.
And Pirate Pete and Pirate Polly are really, really good.
And they have a noisy button, don't they? I used to have that book at home.
Did you? Yeah.
Yeah.
So these are called low-handed books.
Oh.
Have you seen these?
No, I've not
it's a bath time or potty time, you just hang it out the door, because potty time, we read a book,
yes,
calm the child down.
But it's really supportive, because like all the time I have parents say to me, oh, they don't want to wash their face, or they don't want to get in the bath, or they don't want to clean their teeth.
Yeah.
But then you can also use books for other things, like bigger times, where starting school, or having a baby, or travel. I saw earlier on over here you had a few books like that. Yeah, Two Homes.
Yeah.
There was the little collection of firsts as well. My first experiences I saw.
This one is about a little boy who has a little baby, and he said he feels everything is changing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's beautifully illustrated. He feels that the kettle has a ear. These are little emotions that you can bring to the child. For example, you know, you can talk about books on kindness. It's about sharing. There's just so much. You can just bring a lot of books.
I know you have some lovely books.
I know.
5 minutes piece, that's a classic.
but
no, you've had some books before about loneliness and feelings and things like that as well.
How am I feeling? I'm proud, I'm angry, I'm sad. So this one is the first experience.
Yes, that's the one I saw earlier.
This one is something which I always recommend to toddlers, especially nursery going children, because it's got a collection of everything. Going on a plane, my first time going to a hospital, my first time going to the doctor, moving houses.
Yeah.
So these are transition books.
Everyday transition. Yeah. And then we can't not talk about it.
Yeah.
We're nearly there. It's nearly Christmas. Can you believe it?
Yes.
So, do you have many Christmas collections?
Of course we do. Please
and gift ideas as well.
Yes. Can you see? Ta-da! This is just one shelf. We still have more there. This is because the nursery section we have.
So we have some like really. I remember having these when my son was little. Yeah, that's not my Santa. It's got all the little touch and feel. Really lovely.
We have snowman. We have the nutcracker. We have this one.
I've not seen this one before.
This was the one that's published this year, which
really nice.
Again, you see, it's board book, and it's just interesting to get the child's attention.
And then some of the like the nutcracker story.
You have the nutcracker. We have
the stinky sprouts. I like that story.
We like this. We like One Christmas Journey.
Yeah,
this again with the touch and feel element. We have the best Christmas ever.
Lot of
Christmas books. We also got Snowman, Stickman, all these classics that we have the children can read. So there's a book for everybody.
And every language.
And every language.
So what languages do you have?
So we have a little bit of French, but we have a lot of Arabic. And I can show you some of the Arabic. Also have for learners, we have these Arabic alphabet bingos, and this one is one of my favorite of the story. So it's a story, but it's like a wheel, so
interactive.
So this is one of our best sellers. And for non-Arabic speakers, we all who are learning Arabic, I always like to introduce these kind of books, which are just one line, but they're stories that the children know.
Okay,
so they're
easy to follow.
So even though the language is new to them, but they're going to understand the story, so they're not going to get into
it. the alphabet bingo for learning the Arabic alphabet. That's lovely.
Yeah, so they're cute.
Very nice.
Very, very nice.
Wow, you really do have something for everybody.
Yeah.
Children and adults.
So this one is again one of my favorite books, because it's a board book with big pictures, just one vegetable
nice
or apple,
and
then so it's easy for children to learn. I always suggest don't anything should be clear. Simplicity is a key.
Yeah.
Children have a long life ahead of them to learn a lot, but we have to inculcate the habit of enjoying reading and just lay back, relax, read what they like.
It's lovely.
Yeah.
It's nice to take time every day, even if it's just 10-15 minutes with your child, either before bed or even when they're in the bath, if that's the only time they will sit still and read a story with them. It's really, really good. And it's nice quality time to spend together. So thank you for showing us around.
Yeah.
But before you go, we have our announcements to make. So Malar is going to announce the winner of our Instagram competition. So Malar,
say it to you. Thank you so much first for all the lovely participants. We were so pleased with all the beautiful responses that we got.
We were very good.
But the winner is Miss Pushpanjali.
Yeah, thank
Congratulations.
You.
Well done, you. Well
so
done.
So we will get in touch with you. And thank you very much for joining us today. Don't forget to come and visit.
Yay, please come to Booktopia. We all have a Kangaroo Kids collaboration and we're so happy to welcome all Kangaroo Kids parents. Or you can come, just ask any of our staff and we're here to help you, and you also have a discount with to all the Kangaroo Kids teachers and parents. So I'm hoping to see all of you here.
Thank you very much. Have a great day, guys. Bye.